Honestly, on the day of egg retrieval, patients can expect to be here about 2 to 3 hours. What happens is that they are placed under general anesthesia for a very short period of time, only about 10 to 15 minutes, under the care of an anesthesiologist here at RSC and our wonderful surgical staff. And basically what they do is they take a large needle and go through the vaginal wall so that they can access the ovaries. They then drain all the follicular fluid that they see and send all that fluid out to the lab so that they can determine the number of mature eggs that are there for insemination. The male partner is often here producing the sample at the same time if a fresh sample is going to be used. There are certainly other times when we're using donor sperm samples or samples from an autologous male that are frozen, in which case, the timing of that is planned out by our embryology staff. Basically, what happens is the eggs are inseminated, and then our embryology staff watches over them for the next few days to see how they're growing and dividing, and they are assessed at least once daily to make sure and see how they're progressing along.